Hello and welcome to my channel. So in this video I'll be discussing about a technique which you can use to enhance your memory power so that you can retain things for longer and recall them better. So before we actually get to the technique of how we can improve our memory, we'll first understand how human memory actually works. So the single unit of human brain is called a neuron, and neurons are linked to each other through bonds. So the stronger these bonds are, the longer that information that is stored in them can be held, and the easier it will be able to be recalled. So we can take this X as a neuron and this hyphen as a bond between the neurons. So the stronger these bonds are, the longer we will be able to remember whatever is stored in them and recall them. So now we'll get to the technique of how we can actually improve our memory. So we can break this down into a small 4-stage process, which is input, processing, storage, and then output, or directly processing and output. So now here I have written down some matter which we can discuss on each stage in detail. So the input stage is when you are feeding data into your brain. So imagine that you are feeding something into your brain for the very first time, and you don't have any background material to which you can link what you are studying. So at that time, it's advisable that you read in a place where there's lesser external distractions, and you keep your mind free from any distractions so that you'll be able to concentrate better. So this first time reading will be forming the base so that the next time when you go through the same matter, you'll have this base to which you can link that, and you will be able to recall things better. And the next stage is the processing stage. So in this stage, we'll be linking what we are studying now with something which we have already studied earlier. So if in processing stage, the link should be formed in such a way that you'll be able to recall that link, so that you'll be getting to know the underlying matter. Say for example, let me take an example of an accident or a car crash or something like that. So that event would have actually happened for just 5 to 6 seconds, but the bond that is formed in your brain will be so strong that even after 5-6 decades you will be able to recall that accident. So the link that is formed in your brain is so strong for that matter. So in this processing stage, it's very important to form a good logic by which you are linking what you are studying to something which you already know. You can create a small fun story, or some kind of memes, or mnemonics or short forms or anything like that to which you are linking what you are studying now with something which you already know earlier. And then storage. So if you want to keep that bond strong for a longer time, you'll have to frequently recall these things so that bond is refreshed and it will be there for a longer time. So the brain stores things using priority. So if you categorize something as not high priority or not very important, the bonds formed will be weaker and it will get erased in probably a day or two, or maybe a week to the max. But if you want that to stay for a longer time, it's advisable to revise that and recall on a frequent basis, so that when you actually need it, you'll still know the entire thing. And then finally we come to the output stage. So if the above 3 stages happen properly, then output will naturally be proper. But there is one small hitch, that is, you may end up blacking out in your exam. So you may not be able to recall the full thing. So at that time, it's advisable that you relax so that you can recall the whole thing in the exam hall when you need it the most. So by relaxation, you're giving your mind time to go through the memory that is stored and recall the proper things which you need to write the exam. And this technique, you can name it, I have named it as the power of association, and you can name it whatever you like it as. But so this is the technique which you can use to improve your memory by multifold, and this is the same technique by which our brain works. So this is a very proven technique which I have used in my exams, and they have helped me a lot, and I hope that it helps you as well for your professional exams. This is highly useful, especially for students who are taking up professional exams like, you know, company secretary or chartered accountancy, where we need a lot of memory space so that we have to, you know, we can recall things, especially in theory papers like law and taxes, where we need a lot of memory space to, you know, properly recall things in our exam. So I hope this technique can help you prepare better for your exam and score better marks. So thank you for watching.